The next chapter, باب قول الله تعالى وعلى الله فتوكلوا إن كنتم مؤمنين. That means put your trust in Allah if you are believers indeed. See, the sequence is in place, right? If you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, if you have the certainty in the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, that means this is where you perfect your tawheed now. We talked about tawheed and the obligations of it and the virtues of it and so on, and what negates it and the shirk and the details of the shirk. Now we are ready to learn about what perfects the tawheed, right? So the foundation of being away from what negates one's tawheed completely, of matters of shirk, of have deficiency of it, we have to learn that. And we're not satisfied by this unless we work on completing our tawheed, which we mentioned it earlier. So the tawheed is that you do the foundation so that you save yourself from the shirk, and you are in the fold of al-Islam with the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and protect oneself from major and minor shirk. And then a person might still have deficiency in the tawheed. We complete this tawheed with these types and acts of worship to be done sincerely for the sake of Allah. That's why at-tawakkul, putting the trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as clearly mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, is the highest level of the tawheed. This is the highest level of tawheed. When a person has this tawakkul, when he depends with his heart truthfully on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he leaves all of his affairs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while taking the means. This is what the tawakkul is. Your heart dependent totally on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing of the creation of Allah, while you're taking the physical means. It's not like you abandon the physical means, you take the physical means, but your heart is dependent totally on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a result of that, if the physical means tell you to obey the disbelievers in disobeying Allah, the heart would never even think of that. Why? Because it's totally depending on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person would understand that these are not the physical means. The physical means are the permissible ones. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَتَوَكَّلُوا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. If you are believers, then put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And if you make tawakkul on other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is shirk. Why? Because tawakkul is ibadah. The tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a condition for the iman. And whoever does not have the tawakkul of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he does not have al-iman, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are believers, then put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the next ayah, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَدَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. The believers are only those who, when Allah is mentioned, feel a fear in their hearts, and when His verses are recited unto them, they, meaning the verses, increase their faith and they put their trust in their Lord alone. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. And as we mentioned before, in the Arabic language, when you start the sentence with the jar and the majroor, وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ comes before يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Right? On Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they put their trust. That means there's no other room for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to putting their trust. It does not say yatawakkaluna ala Allah, that they put their trust in Allah. This can give some meaning. Maybe they would put their trust on other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when it starts wa ala rabbihim, on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means alone. They put their trust, or they depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And as we heard in the verse, it shows that when they have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their hearts become full of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and their iman increases. So the iman increases and decreases, increases with the good deeds and decreases with the bad deeds. And that the tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from the characteristics of the believers. And the next verse, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ حَسْبُكَ اللَّهُ وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَكَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah is sufficient for you and for the believers who follow you. Allah is sufficient. حَسْبُكَ اللَّهُ, meaning what? That you don't need anyone. Sufficient meaning, if it's sufficient for you to do something, that means you don't need to do anything else. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for you. That means you don't need anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't need no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not of exaggeration. This is how truthful it is. We take the physical means, but we don't need no one. We need only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. we depend with our hearts on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that changes the hearts of the people, and that's why we depend on Him alone. So the call is to the Prophet and to those who follow the Prophet. And this verse is always, the ulama, they mention it to show that the more you are following the Prophet, the more you will have the share of the tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you will have the perfectness of happiness. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhan nabiyyu hasbukallah. Allah is sufficient for you, and Allah is sufficient for those who follow you among the believers. That means if you have a deficiency in your following of the Prophet, that means there will be deficiency in the kifaya, that on the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you will be not as much according to how much you are deficient in following the Prophet. If you perfect your way of following the Prophet, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be enough for you. All the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to you. Then look at ourselves individually and collectively and the whole ummah in general. Right? If the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following the Prophet, how close or far away they are following the Prophet, you would find how much help they are getting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Clearly stated in the verse. Right? As a result of putting the trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following the way of the Prophet. And then the next verse, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever puts his trust in Allah, then He will suffice him. Whoever puts his trust in Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffice him. Will be, you don't need, and this is the easiness of the deen of Allah. Your heart does not have to be diverted in many places and trying to please this and that and going like that. No. Just concentrate on pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. You would find that you're doing physical actions and the heart is attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. This is the sweetness of al-Iman. This is the tranquility and peace. But the person has to have the courage to apply that. He has to have the courage and the bravery to apply that and to be patient. And he has to be tested. But definitely it never fails. A person will be protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then after that he says, وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل قالها إبراهيم عليه السلام حين ألقي في النار وقالها محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حين قالوا له إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا. عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما he said, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل, which means, or حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل, which means Allah alone is sufficient for us and He is the best disposer of affairs for us. Was said, this statement was said by Ibrahim alayhi salam when he was thrown into the fire. And it was said by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam when they, meaning the hypocrites, they said, verily the people, meaning the pagans, have gathered against you, a great army, therefore fear them. But it only increased them in faith. وقالوا, and they said, حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. After returning from the battle of Uhud, and the hypocrites or so, they said to the Prophet ﷺ that the disbelievers are gathering again for you and coming back to fight against you, O Prophet of Allah. And they were coming back with their wounds and so on. As we know, the Prophet ﷺ and his companions, they said, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. Allah is sufficient for us and He is the disposer of our affairs. Right? The heart is full of that trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after that, فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٍ وَاتَّبَعُوا رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ. That they, as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them victory. And they didn't have to fight the disbelievers, they ran away. And this is the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a result of them putting their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And then the verse after that come that we recited in the previous chapter, إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. It is the shaitan that put the fear in you from his supporters. Right? This is the sequence of the verses. That means what? That means turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. This knowledge that we keep hearing it, right? It should never be only things that we hear. We have to act accordingly. We have to be truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He's sufficient for us subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this issue of keep on struggling for the rest of our life with the penny and the dollar and this and that, that it comes from other than Allah, that we need to, what are we going to do if we obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? All these struggles, a person has to go over it and to have the certainty in the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and getting to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. So this tafweed, putting the trust totally on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is something that is the highest level of al-Iman, as we heard. And that brings the goodness of this life and in hereafter.